This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Opotiki, Pitiki, Maori. Opotiki is a small town in the eastern Bay of Plenty in the North Island of New Zealand. It houses the headquarters of the Opotiki District Council and comes under the Bay of Plenty Regional Council. Contents 1 Demographics 11 Population 12 Ethnicity of the District 13 Tribal 2 Natural History 21 Geography 22 Geology 23 Botany 24 Zoology 3 Human History 31 Early Maori History 32 Late 18th to Early 19th Century 33 Warfare 34 Recent History 4 Notable People 5 See also 6 Notes 7 References 8 External links Demographics All figures are based on the 2006 census, from Statistics New Zealand Population of the town, 4,176 Male 1,989, female 2,187 8,973 people usually live in Opotiki District, male 4,431, female 4,545 Its population ranks 63rd in size out of the 73 districts in New Zealand. Opotiki District has 02% of New Zealand's population. Ethnicity of the district Maori 575% European Pakeha 484% other or undefined comprise the balance 4,884 Maori usually live in Opotiki District. Its Maori population ranks 36th in size out of the 73 districts in New Zealand. 09% of New Zealand's Maori population usually live in Opotiki District. Tribal IWI based within the district are Te Fukatahia from Ohiwa Harbour to Opape, including Opotiki Township. Ngāti Tai are based in Toriri. Te Whānau e Apanui and Hapu Te Ehutu cover the area from Hawaii to Potaka. Natural History Geography The Opotiki District is bounded on one long side by the eastern half of the Bay of Plenty embayment of the Pacific Ocean and on the other long side by the Rakamara Mountain Range, which rises to 1754. The town of Opotiki is situated exactly on latitude 38 degrees south. The climate is temperate. Summer temperatures reach the mid-20s Celsius, mid-70s Fahrenheit on the coast and encourage a continuation of the beach culture of the Bay of Plenty. Winter days are often cloudless. The daytime temperature never drops below freezing, but there may be a mild frost at night. Winter snow falls along the crest of the ranges, and on the higher peaks over 1,000 meters may remain for a few weeks. Rain occurs at any season. Severe localized rainstorms cloudbursts may occur in the high country and have caused flash flooding, including past inundations of Opotiki Township. Geology Geologically, the district is predominantly greywacke of late Jurassic to late Cretaceous age, draped by wind-blown loess during the Pleistocene ice ages and more recently covered in volcanic ash and pumice from the Rotorua and Taupo volcanic centers. The active volcano Fukari, White Island lies offshore and represents a tsunami risk. Earthquakes are also a risk, but the district lies just off to the east of major fault lines and the risk is less than in other nearby areas. There are no valuable mineral resources, although the greywacke contains rare decapitated guyets which have been mined in the past for gold and copper. Botany Natural vegetation is preserved in many parts of the district because of the unsuitability of steep land for cultivation. The district is at a natural geographic and climatic boundary. It is the southern limit for mangroves Avicennia resinifera on this side of the North Island of New Zealand, the southern limit for the coastal tree Tarare Bielschmedia tarare, and the mountains are the furthest north for many New Zealand alpine plants Ranunculus insignis, Aurishia caespitosa etc. A remnant sea level stand of an alpine southern beach Nothofagus solandri exists at the head of Ohiwa Harbour, a drowned ice ages valley system. Coastal forest consists of Pohutukawa trees, Nikau palms, and many small shrubs belonging to genera such as Pseudopanax, Coprosma etc. Of particular note are a daisy-flowered shrub Oleria pachyphylla endemic to the district, and the rare large-flowered broom Carmichaelia williamsii. Further inland is temperate rainforest. The canopy is dominated by tall trees such as Tawa, Puriri and Pukatia, heavily populated by epiphytes ferns, lily and orchid families and lianas which include a pandanaceous climber Kiekie. The understory contains many ferns of various sizes including tree ferns up to 10 meters high, the giant stinging nettle Urtica ferox and the extremely poisonous tutu shrub. In mountainous areas the rainforest gives way to less dense Nothofagus beech forest. The understory is dominated by Ghania sedges with sparse shrubs such as the foul-smelling Coprosma fetidissima. Above the treeline there is tough-leaved Oleria shrub and alpine herb field. The diminutive alpine tutu shrub Coriaria potsiana is endemic to the district. The lower river valleys and adjacent tablelands provide productive farming areas, whilst exotic plantings for commercial timber, mainly Pinus radiata, occur on the fringes of the hill country. Zoology introduced animal species considered to be pests: deer, pig, goat, possum are common in the forested areas, and feral sheep and cattle can be found as escapees from adjacent farmland in the developed areas. Birdlife is a mix of introduced pastoral species from Britain: blackbird, song thrush, various finches, sparrows, pheasant, mallard duck, harrier hawk, California quail, and native species such as tui, fantail, gray warbler, waxeye, kingfisher, pukeko. In the forested areas, the bird life is mainly native species, which in addition to the above include wood pigeon kariru, blue duck whio, bellbird, moraport native owl. In the past, the rare North Island kokako, a blue wattled bird, has been sighted. Indigenous freshwater fish, apart from eels, are all small species and are caught as whitebait. In season, introduced trout are found in some rivers. The district is rich in sea life such as mollusks pipi, tuatua, kina, scallop, crayfish, edible fish such as snapper, kahawai and gurnard. Commercial aquaculture is beginning. Mussel, oyster. Human history. Early Maori history. The first known inhabitants of the district were probably members of the Tini o Toi people, who apparently derived from the Takitimu Waka, which came to the Whakatane area from Taranaki. There followed, perhaps a few generations later, the Tainui and Tearawa people, from the first of which the present Naitai tribe claimed direct descent. Also in this period were migrations by the Nukatere Waka from Taranaki, and the Rangimatoru Waka several more generations later. The Matatua people arrived at Whakatane from a place called Paranuatera, which could be either Young Nick's Head or a place on Ahuahu, Great Mercury Island. The present-day Te Whakatahia and Te Whano A Apanui Iwi claim descent from the intermarriage of Matatua with earlier migrants, the overland migration called Te Heke o Te Rangihuhiri, which eventually resulted in the Naitarangi tribe of Tauranga, also contributed to the population. One of the earliest Whakatahia ancestors, Tarawa, deliberately concealed his origins and claimed to have swum to the district from across the sea, supported by supernatural fish he called his pets or children Potiki. Coming ashore just west of Opotiki, he installed his pets into a spring, which thereby became imbued with his mana. The spring Opotiki Mai Tawhiti of the children from far away became famous, and the short form of the name later came to be applied to the district as a whole. Opotiki therefore means the place of children. Late 18th to early 19th century. Hiona St. Stephen's Anglican Church, completed by Reverend Carl Volkner in the 1860s. The first contact between local Maori and Europeans was in 1769 when Captain James Cook passed down the Bay of Plenty coast. Early in the 19th century, a few European and American traders and whalers began to visit. The 1820s saw numerous well-armed invasions by Napuhi war parties from Northland. Although the Opotiki tribes had begun to acquire firearms by that time, they were outgunned and had to retreat from the coast to the rugged forested interior. The 1830s to 1840s were more peaceful, and the tribes again returned to the coast to take advantage of trading opportunities with trading and whaling ships. Maori Christian missionaries began to instruct in literacy and religion in 1840. The Treaty of Waitangi was taken around to be signed, establishing British sovereignty in name. At least Johnna Wilson, a lay missionary of the Church Missionary Society, established the Opotiki Mission in 1840. Soon after, French missionaries moved into the area. At this period, the village at Opotiki was known as Pa Kofi. There were other important villages at Tunapahor and Te Kaha. The 1850s and early 1860s saw continued development. The Maori tribes took up European agricultural methods and crops, primarily wheat, pigs and peaches, which were traded with Auckland. There were still only a few Westerners living in the district, fewer still of whom were British by birth. Among these foreigners were Dr. Albert Agassiz, 1840-1910, distant cousin of the famous Swiss-American scientist Louis Agassiz, and Carl Volkner, a German missionary who had gone over to the Anglican Church. Warfare. A statue on Main Street commemorating the progress of civilization. The British invasion of the Waikato resulted in the Whakatahia tribe lending their support to anti-British forces. In 1864, a war party was sent to assist the related Naitarangi tribe, who had defeated the British at Gate Pa, but while making their way along the coast, the war party was attacked by combined British and Tearawa forces. The paramount chief of the Whakatahia, Te Aporatanga, was taken prisoner and then executed by the wife of an Arawa chief who had been killed in the battle. While this action was compatible with ancient Maori custom, the fighting had hitherto been conducted according to Christianized rules of engagement, and this was accordingly taken as a sign that the British were no longer to be considered considered as a civilized enemy, so in accordance with Maori custom, Utu revenge was taken by killing the missionary Carl Volkner, who had been recruited as an agent by the British governor, Sir George Grey, and who had been transmitting secret reports. The so-called Volkner incident resulted in the invasion of Opotiki by British forces in 1865. Within a few years, the Opotiki district had been settled by military settlers, and the Maori tribes had been confined to villages with little land attached. A desultory guerrilla war followed, led by Fukutahia chief Hira Te Popo and Tuho chief Eru Tamaikofa, but they eventually surrendered and were given amnesty. Warfare again erupted in 1870 when the guerrilla chief Te Kuti shifted his operations to the area for a few years. He and his followers lived in the rugged Te Wira area in the extreme southwest of the Opotiki district. After an amnesty was granted, he eventually moved to Ohiwa Harbor on the coast between Opotiki and Fukutane, where he later died. Recent history: when peace eventually came to the district, most of the cultivable land had been taken by British settlers and was converted to sheep and cattle, later dairy farming. By the end of the 19th century, a generation of both settlers and Maori had grown up together, and there was some form of accommodation, including intermarriage. The district lost men to the two world wars, but an even greater blow was the Spanish flu pandemic of 1918-1919, which devastated small villages because of the relatively small area of cultivable hinterland and a treacherous harbor entrance. Early hopes of Opotiki town becoming a major center for the Bay of Plenty were dashed during the 20th century. The town suffered from repeated shifts of businesses and local government to Fukutane, a situation which has only begun to reverse very recently with increasing population. Major floods in the 1950s and 1960s led to the protection of the town by levees, stopbanks, which have successfully prevented any further inundations. A major boost to prosperity occurred with the kiwifruit boom of the late 20th century. Mussel farming is the next project for develop the town, alongside kiwifruit and bike riding in the Motu Trail becoming popular with locals and tourists. Notable people: James Rawlis, an actor known for his role in Boy and Vodafone NZ advertisements, Lives and was raised in Opotiki. See also Mayor of Opotiki. Notes: Carrot subnational population estimates at the 30th of June 2016 provisional statistics. New Zealand, the 21st of October 2016 retrieved the 21st of October 2016. Carrot quick stats about Opotiki. Carrot Higginbotham. Carrot Phillips, p. 142-144, mentions Kokako in the context of possible sightings of the extinct Huia. Carrot Lyle, p. 137. See also Halbert, p. 37-46. Carrot Lyle, p. 2. Walker, p. 1112. Carrot Lyle, ch. 20. Carrot Lyle, ch. 21. Carrot Lyle, p. 151. Carrot Rogers, Lawrence M. 1973. Te Wairamu, a biography of Henry Williams. Pegasus Press. Carrot Cowan, Volume 2, Chains 10. Carrot Walker, p. 95-122. Carrot Cowan, Volume 2, CHS 37-42, Binney, p. 227-231. Especially Map 5. Carrot Binney, ch. 14. References: S. Beadle, C. Acroyd, P. DeLange, P. Cashmore, W. Shaw. Wellington, 1978, Volume 2, ISBN 978-0-477-01034-4. Ranginui Walker, Opotiki Mai Tawhiti, Capital of Fukutahia. Penguin, 2007, ISBN 978-0-14-300649-7. External links: Wikimedia Commons has media related to Opotiki, the council site Opotiki Information Center, Opotiki Travel Guide from Wikivoyage, Photo of Opotiki, Gisborne Road C19 928, photo of Captain Porter and Maori auxiliaries at Opotiki 1871 VE, Territorial Authorities of New Zealand Cities, Auckland, Hamilton, Tauranga, Napier, Palmerston North, Porirua, Upper Hutt, Lower Hutt, Wellington, Nelson, Christchurch, Dunedin, Invercargill Districts, North Island, Far North, Whangarei, Kaipara, Thames, Coromandel, Hauraki, Waikato, Matamata, Piako, Waipa South, Waikato, Otorowanga, Rotorua, Waitomo, Taupo, Western Bay of Plenty, Fukutane, Kawarau, Opotiki, Gisborne, Wairoa, Hastings, Central Hawke's Bay, New Plymouth, Stratford South, Taranaki, Ruapehu, Whanganui, Rangitiki, Manawatu, Tararua, Harofanua, Kapiti Coast, Masterton, Carterton South, Wairarapa South Island, Tasman, Marlborough, Buller, Grey Westland, Kaikoura, Hurunui, Waimakariri, Selwyn, Ashburton, Timaru, Mackenzie, Waimate, Waitaki, Queenstown, Lakes Central, Otago, Clutha, Gore Southland, Other Chatham Islands, Territories, Tokelau, Ross Dependency, Associated States, Cook Islands, Niue authorities in italics are unitary authorities.